If I'm being completely honest, I'm very distracted right now. In this moment, I don't exactly know why, but it's a challenge right now for me to feel present and calm, and I just wanted to share that with you because few of the next things I'm going to do are gonna kind of be for me as well as you. So just bear with me. But I'm gonna take this opportunity to connect with you. So can you just tell me what you're hoping to get from this session today? Okay. Now let's take a deep breath in together. Again, breathe in. Good. I'm gonna drop my shoulders and I invite you to do the same. I carry a lot of tension in my shoulders. So I'm just correcting my posture. Letting my body tell me where I'm tense is the next step. And right now I'm feeling very drawn to lifting my hands over my head and just twisting back and forth a bit. Whatever you feel led to do, whether it's stretch, or pop your knuckles, down, sit up. Take a few seconds to do that. I painted my nails this fun color. It's kind of a like orange red. It's supposed to be a little spooky. It's the black and red. We can focus on them together to get us back into the present moment. Now, one, two, three, focus on me. Shushing those thoughts, distractions. We are here, we are now, we're connected, you and me. There is a bit of time difference between you and me, but we're connecting nonetheless, it is a real virtual phenomenon. And I'm just very thankful to be with you right now. And I'm honored that you're choosing to spend your time with me. Hand on your belly, I'm putting mine on my diaphragm and letting my belly relax and breathe normally. And that's it. I feel much better, and I hope that was helpful to you too. Now let's focus our attention back on you. Okay, I don't want to hog the attention here, so let's focus on you. I'm going to ask you to do something that might make you a little bit uncomfortable. So there's no pressure to do it, but I do think it'll help. Okay. I would like to pull and snip some anxieties for you. But in order to do that, I need you to think of what's bothering you so that I can see it, pull it away, and snip it. So maybe something's already come to mind. Think of 2 to 3, however many things that have been worrying you, causing you unneeded stress or anxiety, and just allow them to take center stage for a moment. I know it's uncomfortable. But now we're going to consciously let them go. They're out of our control right now. We don't need to worry about them right now. But we need to acknowledge them in order to say goodbye to them, right? Yeah. That makes sense to me anyways. So, have you thought of a few things that you would like me to pull away and snip? Okay. What I'm seeing here. Again, thank you for trusting me in this process. Pull. Is to remind myself that I am in charge of my thoughts, and I can truly just let something go. It takes practice, and it takes discipline, but the more you practice redirecting your focus, saying to a thought, no longer entertaining it, you can invite a thought in, you can host it, you can offer it a drink, you can sit down with it, you can have a conversation with it, or you can check and see who's at the door and then close it and be like, no, not today, not right now. Right now, I'm just gonna continue. And as I do this, replace these anxieties, these intrusive thoughts, whatever they are, with good things that you want to focus on. It could be flowers. It could be puppies. It could be your favorite picture. It could be your favorite song. A friend that you love. Whatever it is. How you feel right now. Check in with yourself. How does your body feel? Sore, tired, comfortable? How about I switch off some intrusive thoughts and anxieties now. Just closing off the parts of your brain that would go to the door and see who's there. I'm using the thought metaphor. Just gonna switch those areas off so you can just be in this like bubble. Good thoughts. Protected, if you will. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna turn off those negative parts that have a place, but we don't want them right now. Yeah. Okay. Going to switch them off. Now, we need to clean up the mess. Very important. So I'm just sweeping it up. A mindfulness meditation. And the goal of this is to just observe your thoughts. You don't have to identify with them. You don't have to believe them. You don't have to judge them. You are merely observing your thoughts. So, I'm going to be your anchor of sorts, reminding you that we are in a meditation. I'm going to do that by just pulling you into the present moment whenever I see that you've gotten distracted, okay? But I am going to be doing the meditation alongside you, so close your eyes if that helps. Allow yourself to settle . You may feel bombarded with thoughts, feelings, visuals. That is completely fine. It's normal. And it is a part of mindfulness meditation. What I'm going to ask you to do is very simple. Observe what your mind . Become the observer. There's no need to judge. Just watch your thoughts like they're clouds drifting. And when you can, bring your focus back to your breath. Bring your focus back to the present. be gentle with yourself. Meet yourself where you are. Remember that you are the observer. You do not have to attach to any thought or feeling. You can just observe it. Now, but do so very gently by brushing your hair using this dark bristly brush. Not sure exactly what it's made of. The meditation make you feel? Meditating, yeah, it is so worth it, but I feel so bad at it. It's the first few moments I close my eyes and start to try to just observe, I get really, really distracted. I used to beat myself up about that, but I really don't think that there's any such thing as a bad meditation. I think it all helps, even if it feels like you just became more aware of how frazzled and chaotic your brain is, that's still a good thing because you're becoming more self-aware. So I don't think there's any such thing as a bad meditation anymore. Although I definitely used to tell myself that, like, ooh, that was a bad session. Just 3 minutes can be a good session. So I'm really proud of you for doing that with me. pushing back from the face, gently bringing you out of the meditation, but hopefully in a way that makes you feel mindful, even though we've stopped practicing the mindful meditation itself. You can focus on the way the brush feels. Pardon my stomach. You could count the brush strokes. Just focus on them. Or just let your mind wander, whatever you want to do. Beautiful and shiny. Have you been using avocado oil? Done this in a while. We're gonna do mirrored touch. So everything that you see this hand doing to my face will be mirrored onto yours. So right now, just using tips, my nail, to, let me fix your hair too, if I'm gonna fix mine, then I need to fix yours, to gently trace the eyebrow outwards, away from the center of the face. It's down the nose, and the ear, gently putting the hair behind your ear. And the nose, gently tapping the nose, and I'm also going to tap the forehead, tap the side. Tap the side. Okay. Now, just gentle under the chin. The hair away from the neck. You're thinking, like, there's what's left. I just had a brain fart on what's the point in cleaning if you just dump all the stuff out without putting it away? Cleaning it up. I don't know what that thought was, but yeah, we're cleaning up. I was imagining dumping out everything that you vacuum, like, in the middle of the floor. I'm tired of this mood I'm in. I really am. Okay. Now we're going to do a mindfulness meditation of sorts, and the goal of this is to leave this session, or really, wow, okay. Now we're going to do a mindfulness meditation. And the goal of this is to get back into the driver's seat of your mind, to be the observer, and to choose what thoughts you want to attach to, but really